Coming up, after one Knott County teacher died suddenly, friends and family are now trying to make her dreams come true. And one former school in Pike County is set for demolition after standing for more than 120 years. Plus, commercial vehicle enforcement officers were doing what they call roadway blitzes to help keep roads safer in the most dangerous traffic of the year.
Dedicated to Eastern and Southern Kentucky, this is WYMT Mountain News This Morning.
Well, good morning. It is 5:31 on Thursday, August the 15th. I'm Will Puckett. Thank you for tuning into Mountain News This Morning. Well, some might be getting in a little bit of rain action this morning, Brandon, but for the most part, it's a little bit of fog and that. Cool temps for the most part.
Exactly, and I think most of the rain is gone so far this morning. Could redevelop in stray form as we head deeper into the day, but as we take a look at the cameras this morning, you can see a little bit of fog not up on top of Whitesburg Pine Mountain this morning, but it's around the rest of the region. Zero visibility, Logan, close to that in Jonesville. A lot of folks below that 5-mile threshold this morning, basically everyone. So be careful out there, and of course, buses back on the road, so be careful and watch out for those as well. Temperatures in the low 60s out toward Lake Cumberland. Everybody else in the mid to upper 60s. One lone 70, Jacksboro, Tennessee. So a few degrees cooler this morning. 7 degrees colder in Somerset and Monticello from yesterday. Everybody else about 3 to 4, 5 degrees cooler than it was this time yesterday morning. Your app cast today. You can track any stray showers we have on that. It's free on all the app stores. And you can see partly cloudy skies for a little while this morning. So a few clouds in the mix. And then we'll see temperatures soar under mostly sunny skies today, about 87 for a daytime high. The rest of the forecast is on the way here in just a few minutes. Will?
All righty, Brandon, thank you. Well, after one Knott County teacher died suddenly this summer, friends and family are trying to make her dreams come true by raising money to help her students with reading and math. WYMT's Lauren McCourt has more.
Morgan Hall was a well-loved teacher here at Jones Fork Elementary.
Kids loved Morgan.
Her compassion and care for her students and coworkers shined through.
Instantly, it was like two pieces of a puzzle coming together.
Back in July, Morgan died after giving birth to her son.
Morgan died shortly after her dream of being a mother.
Devastating not only her family, but the entire community.
Her death has really left a hole in their hearts.
Though her dream of becoming a mother was short, Morgan's family did not want her death to stop other dreams from coming true.
Morgan was very passionate about children learning to read and comprehend.
Struggling with dyslexia for her entire life, Morgan was very interested in computer programs that could possibly help students with similar struggles.
Our school's not able to fund it.
With the school unable to fund the programs, that's when her family stepped in to help.
Her family is now trying to provide a dream of Morgan's.
Hoping to raise $20,000.
Really what it would mean for people to donate is to help Morgan's dream come true.
To make another dream come true for their sweet Morgan. In Knott County, Lauren McCourt, WYMT Mountain News.
Now you can help make Morgan's dream come true by going to a community trust bank location and donating to Morgan's mission fund. Well, as the new semester begins, we learned that children enrolled in special education programs have doubled in the past 9 years. Summer programs such as Camp Leap in Laurel County provide focus to those children that are challenged socially and behaviorally. But what about during the school year? Local radio host Kip Jervis and his daughter Jaslyn teamed up to write and produce Your Eyes, a song highlighting his nephew Zion and other special needs children, saying they deserve more from others out throughout life.
We feel responsible, as we should. We're here for them and we're here to serve them, and we should do that, okay? But what if it's the other way around? What if they're here for us? Pay attention to them. They have a lot to teach us.
Now, so far, the video has been viewed more than 10,000 times on Facebook. Jervis says he hopes to be involved with any programs the county may come up for special needs children in the future. One man in Pike County is giving the Camp Creek community a chance to say goodbye to one of its oldest structures. Josh Mayhorn began attempts to restore the old Camp Creek schoolhouse in the stopover community earlier this year. He soon realized restoration was not an option and decided to tear down the more than 120-year-old building. He says the building served as one-room schoolhouse from the early 1890s, closing in the late 1960s. We talked with one former student who says the building once held two sections of chairs for students separated by an old coal stove. He says the memories were not always the warmest.
In the wintertime, a teacher would give me a quarter or 5 cents a week to have a good fire when she come. And if you didn't sit next to the stove, you froze to death.
Blankenship says he will miss the building, bad memories and all, but he looks forward to seeing the home Mayhorn plans to build on the property. Eastern Kentucky lawyers have spent the last 4 years fighting for former Eric C. Kahn clients to get their Social Security benefits back. Finally, close to 500 of those clients should receive a check in the mail soon. WIMT's Katie Cook got an update from attorneys working with some of those clients.
4 long years of waiting.
The whole process has been pretty much a nightmare for the people here in Eastern Kentucky.
Years living without any sort of income.
I've been going through cancer and stuff, and I lost my medical, I lost my benefits, and it's just hard to keep on going.
Lawyers volunteering their time to stand up for those affected by the schemes of Eric C. Kahn.
I can't stress it enough. If it hadn't been for these lawyers, these volunteer lawyers here in Eastern Kentucky, I just don't know what these people would have done.
In recent weeks, attorneys estimate judges ruled in favor of about half of Kahn clients to receive benefits again. But the key, Ryan Mosley says, is making sure clients know the process of getting them back.
It's so important that if you are getting reinstated, even if you're not sure if you're getting reinstated, call the Social Security office, go to your local Social Security office, update your mailing address and your contact information and your banking information.
It is the news people like Robert Martin have longed for.
I'm just grateful. I mean, I really am grateful.
Not just for the money, but for all of the lawyers who stepped up.
It's the most rewarding thing I've done. It's the kind of thing I went to law school to do.
Now they just hope to move on and live again the life that they once knew. In Prestonsburg, Katie Cook, WIMT Mountain News.
Lawyers are hoping some former clients will receive a check in the mail as early as next month. They say a federal class action lawsuit is pending in the Eastern District of Kentucky for those who did not directly take their case to federal court in hopes their benefits will be reinstated also. Right now, we are in the 100 deadliest days for highway fatal crashes. Yesterday, Kentucky State Police's commercial vehicle enforcement officers were doing what they call roadway blitzes. This is part of the TACT campaign. TACT stands for Ticketing Aggressive Cars and Trucks. Officer Jamie Field says they are doing this to keep drivers safe.
When you see all of us out here and you see all the blue lights up and down 119, 23, no matter what road we work, what school zone we work, we're not out here trying to just write tickets.
Now, the year-round program targets specific driving behaviors such as speeding, following too close, DUI, and reckless driving. Field says the fastest speed he clocked for a driver yesterday was more than 85 miles per hour. Well, for several hours, a man's cries for help weren't heard after he fell off a wood wall in Portsmouth, Ohio, and was in a grassy area where he could not be seen. He was there for hours, suffering in pain, wondering if help would ever come. As WSAZ's Taylor Eaton reports, that help finally arrived, thanks to that man's dog, who he says saved his life.
For Jimmy Hale, the minutes and the hours that passed on August 5th seemed more like days.
I just didn't know if anyone would find me.
In so much pain, wondering if help would ever come.
Didn't realize the extent of my injuries until I woke up and I was pretty injured.
Hale was badly injured after falling off a flood wall in Portsmouth while walking his dog Taco.
And this was about 7:45 Monday night, and I woke up it was daytime Tuesday morning, so I was in that woodsy area on the flood side of the wall that whole night. So it had been several hours that I was there. It was a lot of pain, a lot of shouting and asking for help.
His cries for help going unnoticed.
But it seemed like it was forever because the pain was so bad.
Until finally,
heard a lawnmower. And it's the riding lawnmower had come up, and I heard him turn the lawnmower off. And then I start hearing footsteps come toward me.
That man was Mark Puckett, really who works for the city of Portsmouth. He had come to mow grass that day, only figuring out that Hale was there because of this tiny dog that never left.
Thank you for finding me, brother. Appreciate it.
Just it wasn't for her.
Well, I know it wasn't for her, but thank you for kicking it in action.
So, don't know what I could do.
This guy, as soon as he saw me, all he could say is, your dog is amazing. Your dog is amazing. You got an amazing dog.
Is.
I thought he was going to steal my dog after all that.
I think my wife would have put a stop to that.
Hale flown to St. Mary's Medical Center, where he's now recovering, suffering some pretty extensive injuries. But despite that pain, he's been experiencing a greater pain in his heart.
And I haven't seen her face-to-face since last Monday.
Longing to see that little dog that helped save his life. But after more than a week apart, an emotional reunion between man and his best friend. Hale saying he's thankful for Taco and the man that ended up finding him.
They're our heroes. No, I mean, we could not be more thankful for them than anything in this world. I mean, you know, they both saved our brother. They truly did.
In my opinion, Taco's his real hero.
In the end, though, his companion getting the credit and all the love.
Was it for her, I don't know if I would have been found, honestly.
Proving her loyalty to him in a time when he needed her help the most.
You saved my life. Thank you.
Now, Hale did have to have surgery. He had several broken bones. He is going to have to do therapy, and we are told it's still going to be a few days before he can head home. To Nebraska now, as summer vacation comes to an end, one annual Omaha tradition had one pool going to the dogs. Dogs got to join their owners in the water at the Gallagher Pool in Benson. As part of the city's doggy dip tradition, Sunday was the last day for outdoor public pools in Omaha. The event started in 2008 with all the money raised going to help the Nebraska Humane Society. Well, it was a mad dash for cash in Milwaukee yesterday when $2,000 was hidden around the city for the public to track down and keep.
We can do that around here. The next few days could be some of the hottest we've seen so far this summer. How high could the mercury go? The latest in about 3 minutes.